Wednesday, July 16th in the year of our Lord, 2014. How are all y'all doing out there? I'm doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Yeehaw! Western Wednesday. It's Happy Hump Day! Hump Day! Damn right. Two more days till Big and E Fatty. That's what I'm talking about, y'all. Hell yeah. Hey, today's unofficial sponsor of our show, I'm going to give them all big old kudos. Right down here in Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. Same damn state, pretty much. These folks, we got Colin, we've got Catherine, we got a whole plethora of great young folks over there. Human Performance and Rehab. Not Amy Winehouse's kind of rehab, folks. No, 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 no. This stuff right here, physical trainers, stuff like that. Look at that. Remember when I had my ulnar nerve entrapment surgery? Well, I couldn't stretch my arm out very far. Well, these awesome folks, look at that. It's getting better. It's getting much better. Catherine, you were phenomenal today. Thank you, my dear friend. You are awesome. Wicked awesome. That's right. And Colin, phenomenal. All of you over there, abso-freaking-smurfalutely amazing. I hope you all watch the show, spread the word. It's a lot of fun each and every day. If the day ends in a Y, we're doing beer and song in a day. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying, eh? So I'm talking about. Oh, Canada, indeed. You got to give some love to our neighbors up north. Although I'm a proud American. Well, hey, I'm parched. I'm thirsty. I need something to drink. How about the good old Yeehaw Western Wednesday proper beer consumption apparatus? As we bust out today's beer of the day, I need something to kick me in the butt. Because boy, oh boy, what another ball buster of a day at work. So we're going to bring out good old fashioned Dogfish Head Immort Ale. The pride of Milton, Delaware. This stuff, no bull. Look at the strength of that bad boy. 11% alcohol by volume. Yes. It is more than double the strength of a normal beer. No, you will not drive after drinking this here beer. That is dumb. Abso-freaking-lutely dumb. All right, well, I'm parched. Let's bust this puppy open, shall we? Frog beer opening apparatus pup technique. Here we go. 45-degree angle right in your beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm that damn good. Haven't spilled drop yet. Never have, never will. Cheers the beer to all of you pussies, say Germany, goodbye, they say in Japan. Mouthgasm, big solid A on that there beer. Wow. Folks, this stuff is luscious and complex, this smooth, full-bodied ale reveals interwoven notes of maple, vanilla, and oak. Hey, have a little bit of sweetness with your tree, huh? Why not, right? There you go. I'll tell you what, it makes a damn good beer, too. Yeah, baby. All right. We got a plethora of birthdays to get to for today. And one of them is, folks, this is so important to me. One of my true heroes. Oh, he is my hero. My grandfather, my father, heroes, no question about it. My father, Jeff Baker. This guy is a hero. Former Force Recon Marine, Vietnam vet, 1968-1969. Living up in Maine. A true Massachusetts guy just like me. Damn proud of it. Hey, Dad, you know, Maine was part of Massachusetts till 1820, so you're just still living in Massachusetts. Except we don't have to pay them stupid taxes anymore, right? Dad, happy birthday to you. I hope you actually take a break from working your butt off and actually watch the show. Hey, maybe you'll have an adult beverage with your son, you know? Why not, Dad? Right? Hell yeah. Dad, I got a couple songs for you today. I know how much you love Yeehaw truck driving music. Dogs, shut up. Oh, yipper, yapper, and yelper. Good Lord. Dad, you're going to love the songs. Mom, I know you're going to watch the show because you're absolutely awesome. One of our biggest fans. My mom's a former fan of the week multiple times on Beer and Song of the Day. She shares the show pretty much every day. I know my mom's going to share this one. Hey, Dad, maybe you'll share it too. I don't know. Well, Dad, happy birthday to you. And thanks for being the most wicked awesome dad anybody could ever have. Love you. Can't wait to see you guys. And we'll be there later this year. We definitely love you. We definitely miss you. Dad, Trust me, you're going to love the songs today. If not, I'll be shocked. So, Dad, raise it with me. Cheers and beers, and hope you enjoy the show. Happy birthday, Dad, and I love you. All right. Well, now, my father was waiting in Okinawa, Japan. And on the very day that he turned 18 years old, one of the greatest football players to grace God's green earth was born. I normally don't bring out celebrity birthdays mixed in with this, but Barry the Man Sanders, number 20, Detroit Lions, my all-time favorite football player ever. He was born July 16, 1968. The day my father turned 18 was the day that my father was shipped off to WWNOM. Yes, he was. Barry the Man Sanders, my personal favorite all-time football player. I wear his jersey proudly. Representing, baby. Hey, that's my number two favorite football team of all time. Right behind them is my beloved Patriots. Oh, right in front of them is my beloved Patriots. Yes, I have the 1989 score Barry Rookie's rookie card. That thing's worth well over $50. It's probably approaching 100 now. I bought this card cheap. I got paid like $20 for it many years ago, if even that. That one I got for $1. Oh, no. My phone's ringing. Yeah, this is the NFL Pro Set card, rookie card. Yes, Barry was number 21, Oklahoma State. Yeehaw, Cowboys! That's right. Not OU, but OSU. But, of course, my favorite team, Tom Brady. This is a limited edition number 24 out of 1,325 cards. I bought this card for $2 when I went on vacation to Guam many years ago. This card is worth approximately $200. I have no idea, but it's worth a ton. Yeehaw! Barry the Man Sanders, folks, phenomenal autobiography. I'm a big fan of this book, and it even comes with a bonus DVD, which just shows the absolute badassness of one Barry Sanders. Very disappointed. Now, you good folks over at Human Performance and Rehab, oh, minorly disappointed with you, Catherine. Ah, yes, you're a sweetheart of a lady. But you've never heard of Barry the Man Sanders. Ah, unbelievable. Hey, I know it's not yeehaw high school football, college football, but by golly, he was a hell of a running back in college football. Still owns the single season record for most rushing yards, over 2,600 of them, with the Oklahoma State Yeehaw Cowboys. Aye. Well, there you go. Let's get cracking with the rest of the birthdays. My good friend, Joel Biggio. I hope I pronounced that right. Now, Joel, I've actually met through the old Mafia Wars. Hey, Joel, do you still play Mafia Wars? I know you. Last I knew, you were a member of our wicked awesome family, Strays Fight United, the best damn Mafia Wars family on the old Facebook. Well, Joel's the pride of Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. Joel is a big badass of a player when it comes to the old song pop. Joel, we always have a good battle, don't we, brother? And hey, I get it. You don't want no yeehaw country music. You don't want no wrestling. And I don't even remember what the other category was. But it's going to be yeehaw country music today, but old school, classic style. I think you might actually like it, Joel. You'd be surprised. Hell, I used to not like heavy metal because, it was modern. And now I'm just all old school. I'll tell you what, I got a big love for thrash metal. And tomorrow's show will prove that. Shocking. Yes, most of my music prefers the 1947 to 63 era, but I do have a unique love for heavy metal and death metal. Anyway, Joel, happy birthday to you, brother. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969, minus the acid. Cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, my good friend Garrett Cook, another member of Straight Fight United, best damn Mafia Wars family on the old Facebook. Garrett, my friend, Everett, are you still playing the Mafia Wars? I hope you're still part of our family. I know you've always helped me out in the past, but I want to say happy birthday to you. Hey, happy anniversary of coming out of the womb, right? Yeah, that's what a birthday is. That's right, we celebrate it every year. I celebrate it every day. I enjoy life. But Garrett, my friend, happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right, quick moment. I got to show what's on the stove for dinner tonight. It'll be reheated. Oh, I can't wait. My daughter's riding horses with her niece, Allie, and my love goddess. and her wicked awesome mom. They're there watching. Folks, there's two types of meatballs there. Mexican rice. Oh, they'll be more colorful. And made from scratch refried beans. Everything here is made from scratch. I'm telling you, every night I eat like a king. As I was telling my friends earlier over at Human Performance of Rehab, I eat like a king every day. Yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Alright. Well, next birthday, how about my good friend James Isbell? James Isbell, a great leader of men, women, and it's that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. We do know it's the same damn state, pretty much. Well, James, brother, how you doing? Hope you're doing well, and I hope you're celebrating your birthday. Why don't you pour an adult beverage, watch the show with me, drink with me, will ya? And, brother, have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Speaking of drinking with me, I'm trying to pull it up right here, right now, y'all. And it's not doing it because I got the luck of a murder victim with electronic devices. Well, check this out, y'all. Did it pull up? Oh, yeah. Drinking a beer with my favorite doctor, Reverend Dr. B. God, I miss you, brother. This guy lives out in Italy. I worked with him down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. Cris, folks. He was your real hunk of the day on Monday's show. Blues Monday, that's right. Cris getting it on with his good old Golden Drock, 10.5%. Phenomenal beer. I do believe Belgian. You asked me earlier. I've had Golden Drock many times. Stuff's amazing. It's incredible. Trust me, Cris. This stuff is nectar of the gods. Oh, my God. Cris, just wanted to give you a special shout-out in between birthdays. Because, brother, you like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. Excuse me. You earned it. So, yeah, there you go. He's watching my show, drinking with me. Long distance. He's in Italy. I'm here in Yeehaw, Texas. That's cool, Cris. Much respect. Little dogs never shut up, okay? All right. James Isbell, brother. Happy birthday, man. Marcos Trejo, T-R-E-J-O. Marcos, hey, here's a badass age ranger I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Marcos, yo, how you doing, man? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday to you, age ranger, Din Star, because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. That's right. Yeah, I knew it, brother. I woo. Ha! Yeehaw! Well, Marcos, my man, hey, happy birthday, have a wicked awesome day, celebrate well, and enjoy, cheers and beers. Next on the list, the lovely sweetheart of a lady that I know from jolly old England, Cornelia Lansbury. Corn, how you doing, sweetie? Hope you're doing well, a stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady. Her awesome lesser half has a phenomenal first name, Josh, that's right, and he's a cop, that's right. He's helping protect and serve, baby. And his wonderful better half, Corn, just a total sweetheart of a lady. He's absolutely phenomenal. And I know he's going to spoil you on your birthday there, Corn. I know he will, because he's a good guy like that. Take it from the love doctor. I know what I'm talking about. Corn, happy birthday, my friend. Have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my good friend, Eddie Harris. Eddie, I have known since he was a little fetus. No kidding. Eddie Harris, he used to go to, remember Miss Heron? Summer Street, Vineyard Haven, that's right, street over from us, Midland Ave, Vineyard Haven, Massachusetts, Martha's Vineyard Island, that's right. Eddie, happy birthday, buddy. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. A great young man. He's an older man now. Eddie, dude, we feel old, don't we? Don't worry, you still got a few years to go to catch up to my age. Of course, by then I'll be 3 years older, you know, just saying. Well, Eddie, my man, never heard from you in a while. Drop me a line, let me know how you're doing. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Happy birthday. Celebrate well and enjoy. Yeehaw. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, happy birthday to my good friend Celia Shear. C-E-L-I-A-S-C-H-E-E-R. Not S-H-E-E-R. Come on now. Celia is a recent addition to the Mafia Wars crew. Hey, it's all about whacking schmucks and schmuckettes. You know, you get off of work and say, man, what a rough day. Let's go ice some fools. Well, that's what we do, right, Celia? And it's great having you in my Mafia Wars crew, and I'm honored to be in your Mafia Wars crew. Powers in numbers. Teamwork makes the dream work. Celia, happy birthday to you. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my good friend Keith Steinbach. You know, ironically, Keith, somebody was telling me today, a lovely lady that I know here in Yeehaw, Texas, that that the area did an article, the media did an article on somebody with a YouTube show. And I know you don't live in this area. And I know it wasn't me because the media didn't do an article on my YouTube show yet. Maybe someday they will, and I hope they do. Well, my good friend Keith Steinbach, who I know from jolly old England, and a great man indeed, a great professional young man, and this guy, if you think I'm good, this dude is a walking brain. You should see the graphics on the show. Bebop Vox. That's B-E-B-O-V, B-E-B-O-P-V-O-X. All one word. Look for it on the YouTube. Look for it on the old Facebook. Keith Steinbach, if you're into Minecraft the way my daughter is, I'm telling you, this guy, he is your ticket to success. Keith Steinbach, what a privilege and an honor to work with legends like you. You've got a ginormous following. And brother, happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right. The final birthday of the day goes to a real sweetheart of a lady that I know from good old Martha's Vineyard Island. My dear friend Ellen Bernard, as I always knew her, Ellen Blodgett, a real sweetheart, just an awesome friend, and a final standing graduate of Martha's Vineyard Regional High School class of 1992 with my brother. Ellen, always playing me in the song pop, and Ellen, you are whooping the shit out of me this week. Damn! Hey, I've had good weeks against you too, though. Don't forget that now. But Ellen, you are kicking my ass, taking names, killing commies for mommy. Wicked awesome job. I'm going to get you back, Ellen, because as soon as this show's done, as soon as dinner's done, I'm getting on the old song pop, and I'm looking for you. Well, Ellen, my friend, happy birthday, like I'd forget. And have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beer. And Ellen can vouch for the fact that I memorized all 500 birthdays in our high school, students and teachers, and I have not forgotten them. All right, well, I want to give, let's bring out that trivia question, y'all. Folks, it was a simple trivia question, well, at least a real short one. What is a capon? C-A-P-O-N. Well, my good friend Matt Mad Dog Becker, one of the greatest leaders of men, women, and itch you are ever going to find in life. A great Christian man, a great friend, a great mentor, a great supervisor, a great leader, a true leader of men, women, and it's living in Nebraska, the cornholer state, but is from Illinois, a true wicked hardcore Chicago Bears fan, the Bears, and he loves the Packers like he loves getting kicked in the crotch with a steel toe boot, and he'll agree with me on that. Well, Matt Mad Dog Becker, my friend, you and your wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Kris, she is gorgeous. You and I both are saying it. How did we get the women that we are blessed to have? Charm and personality, baby. That's what it is, bro. That's what it is. Ow! My wife had her contacts installed backwards when she met me. She had to have. I'm horrifying to look at. You're studly. You're a former real hunk of the day on Baron Song of the Day. And rightfully so. We may have to feature you again. Maybe someday Kris will want to be featured as a real baby today. We'll pair the two of you together, you know? Just saying. It's up to you, though. It's up to her. Got to have the blessing for that. And for any of you other fans out there, same goes for you. In the meantime, my good friend Matt Mad Dog Becker said this. He said a capon is a small male chicken. It is neutered, from what I understand, but about as yummy as a Cornish hen. Heck, all chicken is awesome. Brother, you're right. Now, I do prefer white meat over dark meat. Dark meat is just a little stronger in flavor and a little too oily and stuff. My wife prefers dark meat. I prefer white meat, but hey, preferences are okay. Nothing wrong with that. But chicken is chicken, and chicken is wicked awesome. And I know you agree with me there. Matt Mad Dog Becker, I am honored and privileged to give you a Love Doctor salute. Oh, hell yeah! And how about a yeehaw? Why not? It is Yeehaw Western Wednesday. Damn right. Alright, so there you go. There's your trivia question. Let's give some quick additional shout-outs. These are important. My good friend Kris Polk, I hooked up already. My good lady friend Kristy Rich, a stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady and a bubble-chasing badass like my good friend Kris Polk. But Kristy Rich, I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Hell, I worked with Kris in Yeehaw, Texas at one time as well, but he moved to Italy, you schmuck. But Kristy Rich, my dear, a wonderful lady, a fellow beer connoisseur, just an awesome, awesome walking bunch of motivation. Yes, you are. No doubt, Kristy. Always great chatting with you. I feel better about myself every day when I talk to you. Same with you, Mad Dog. Same with a lot of you out there. Kristy Rich, my dear. Just wanted to give you a shout out and say, hey, and if Kristy, if you haven't had this here beer, you got to get yourself some. Oh, by the way, swing by my place at work, okay? Swing by the office at work. Do me a favor. I got something for you. I forgot to give it to you today, okay? We were talking about something earlier. You'll be happy, I promise you that. Kristy Rich, my dear. Cheers and beers. Oh, my man Ben Connor. He's moving on to bigger and better things, but what a badass crew dog that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Western Louisiana. I already said that one. Eastern New Mexico. Same damn state. Ben Connor. Dude, I'm going to miss the hell out of you, but you better keep in touch, otherwise I will hunt you down and say, yo, what's up, man? Don't be a stranger. All right? Got to keep in touch. Friendship. Great to have friends all over the world. Trust me, I've got them all over the world. I promise you that. You treat people right, they're going to treat you right. If not, they should have never been born. Karma will bite them in the ass eventually. We all know that. But Ben, just wanted to say, hey, man, definitely going to miss you, brother. And thank you for being so awesome. What an honor to work with people like you, man. Going to miss you. Keep in touch. And to my good friend, Ohyuk Kwan. A dash dude. Dash dude! Hell yeah! A great man indeed. I haven't given you a shout-out in a while, so I told you I'd give you a shout-out today. I hadn't seen you since the Truman administration. It's felt like it's been that long. Ohyuk Kwan, my man, Dr. Kwan. Hell yeah. Let's have an adult beverage together, shall we?
You damn right.
And brother, great work with people like you, man. We need more like you in the world. Do me a favor. Be fruitful and multiply. Have a litter of kids, all right? We want smart people to make the world a better place. And we need people like you to make it happen. You can do it. You can do it all night long. I'm assuming. Cheers and beers. All right. Shoutouts went a little longer than I expected, but that's all right, though. All right, Dad. Here you go. Today's hunk of the day, our beard song of the day. I say you're going to love this one because you are a fan of real truck driving music. And this guy is as truck driving music as it gets. It looks like an Oklahoma University jacket, but it's actually a Dave Dudley jacket. Dave Dudley. And look at that, Pabst Blue Ribbon. Oh, that's some goat piss beer right there. Oh, the finest beer served anywhere since 1844. Sure. If it's the only beer that's being served, then of course it's going to be the best and the worst. All that stuff is rot gut garbage. All right. Well, how about, speaking of beer, how about we play Dave Dudley's famous 1965 song, Two Six Packs Away? Here y'all go. Yeehaw. Hunk of the day music. Two Six Packs Away. Dave Dudley. Dave Dudley. You're hunking it down, beer and song today for Yeehaw Western Wednesday. That's real truck driving music, y'all. I don't care what anybody's saying. He is a truck driving son of a gun. Dad, it was you that I remember playing Dave Dudley back in the late 70s. I remember you playing his music on the 8-track, and you were playing that 1963 classic, 6 Days on the Road. That's Dave Dudley's most famous song, 1963. And Dad, I never forgot it. I'm not going to play that one today because I got something even more special for you.
Lung Slayer. Now, he was born in 1928, passed away in 2003 at the age of 75. That's a real yeehaw country music. Hey, there you go. Y'all know, you play stuff like this backwards, guess what happens? You get your wife back, kids back, your truck back, you get your mobile home back, you get your gun collection back, but most of all, and I do mean most of all, you get that hunting dog back, y'all. So play country music backwards sometimes. Play country music backwards sometime, you'll see what happens, y'all. Hey, a lot of birthdays on this day, famous birthdays. I already mentioned Barry the Man Sanders. Failed to mention till just now my cousin Troy Hindle, the only boy out of the five Hindle kids. And Troy Hindle, I know you're not on the old Facebook. If you are, you haven't checked it since the Nixon administration. Troy, happy birthday to you, cuz. How you doing? Hope you're doing awesome. Want to hear from you. It's been too long since I've heard from you. Hey, and don't worry, Mom. See, I didn't forget Troy's birthday. It just took a moment. I'm getting older and bolder. But hey, cheers and beers, Troy. Happy birthday. Hope you enjoy the show. There you go. A little bit more Dave Dudley right there, y'all. Actor Corey Feldman, 43 years old today. How about Will Ferrell, famous comedian? He's 47. Shoeless Joe Jackson, greatest baseball player ever to not be in the Hall of Fame. Well, yeah, he was actually better than Pete Rose even, possibly. They're right up there. How about that for a Dave Dudley t-shirt? Mm-hmm. All right, well, burn through the rest. Actress Ginger Roger, born on this day, 1911, passed away in 1995. Her and Fred Astaire, famous, most famous dance duo of all time, no doubt about it. Jimmy Johnson, former head coach of the Yeehaw Dallas Cowboys, who haven't won a Super Bowl since 1996, just to throw it out there, y'all. He's 71 years old today. How about Chris Pontius from the TV show Jackass, 40 years old today, milestone birthday. Bobby Lashley, where's my wrestling fans at? Bobby Lashley, 38 years old today. Late great actress Barbara Stanwyck, born this day 1907, passed away in 1990. Super wicked, hardcore, awesome eye candy. Phoebe Cates. Who remembers that movie? Who remembers the movie? Fast Times at Ridgemont High in that pool scene as she comes out topless. And Judge Reinhold is, well, you know, he's holding his own, literally. Yeah, Phoebe Cates, 51 years old today. She still looks fantastic, but good God. She was so hot in the early 80s. Duncan Keith, how about a Chicago Blackhawks player? Badass defenseman, Duncan Keith, 31 years old today. Two-time James Norris Trophy winner. That is the best defensive player in the National Hockey League for the season. He won it in 2010 and 2014. Yeah, he's quite a badass. I could use him on my Bruins, you know. How about Stuart Copeland, drummer of the band Police? Oh, yeah. Considered the fifth best drummer of all time by Rolling Stone magazine. Of course, Rolling Stone magazine is a bunch of communists, and they deserve that. I can't stand them. They don't get my service or my attention. How about Zach Randolph, basketball player, 33 years old today? The late, great Orville Redenbacher. That's right, the popcorn legend. Born this day in 1907, passed away in 1995. Roald Amundsen, the first ever to go to the North and South Pole. Of course, he discovered the South Pole. First to make it to the South Pole, December 14th, 1911. Famous explorer, born this day in 1872, passed away in 1928. No Sean Marino, Denver Broncos running back, beast, 27 years old today. Reuben Blades, singer, not a country singer. Reuben Blades, Latino singer, he's 66 years old today. And then, of course, we got Phil Hellmuth. Yeehaw, Texas Hold'em badass player. Phil Hellmuth is 50 years old today. That guy is awesome. Rain Pryor, actress, daughter of the late great comedian, one of the true legends, Richard Pryor. Thank you, Mom and Dad. We watched Richard Pryor live on the Sunset Strip as little kids. But you know what? We turned out okay, didn't we? Richard Pryor, what a legend. But his daughter, Rain, 45 years old today. Hey, I know somebody that's 45 years old today, but I won't reveal their age. And then finally, we've got Bess Meyerson. Bess Meyerson from the TV show I've Got a Secret, famous game show, the man from 1950 to 67, if I'm not mistaken. She was the first ever Jewish Miss America. I got a hunch she might be a future Babe of the Day on Parents Song of the Day. Well, Bess Meyerson, 90 years old today, milestone birthday, big time. That deserves a Love Doctor salute. Yeah, let's drink to that, shall we? All right. Dad, we're going to finish the show off strong for you. I found this song last night. I got to admit, I hadn't heard it. It's in my music collection. I hadn't heard it. I listened to it twice last night. And I said, yep, this song is perfect for my father. Because see, my father, like I said, he's a Vietnam vet. He's proud. Very proud Vietnam vet. And Dad, I'm proud of you. And folks, this song is by that same legend of a man in Your Hunk of the Day, Dave Dudley. This one's from 1966. And Dave Dudley came out with a song called Vietnam Blues. Squeeze me. And while we do that, let's show off gorgeous, sexy, yeehaw country singer. I don't care how old she is. I know she's above age, and that's all that matters, y'all. How about Kimberly Perry? You ever heard of her, y'all? Let's play Vietnam Blues by Dave Dudley, 1966. And let's show off some eye candy. Dad, I'm going to shut up for a few minutes.
I'm not leaving the time, just stuck in the fog, nosing around like a hungry dog.
All right, y'all, drool over the eye candy and listen to the words.
I saw a crowd of people on the White House lawn, all carrying signs about Vietnam. So I went over to see what was going on. It's a strange-looking bunch. But then, I never could understand some people. Well, a fella came to me with a list in his hand. He said, we're gathered names to send a telegram of sympathy. Then he handed me a pen. I said, I reckon this is going to the kids and the wives, my friends over there who'd given their lives. I said, uh-huh,
yipper, yapper, yelper, shut up.
Ho Chi Minh. I said,
Ho Chi Minh, what a dick.
He said, Ho Chi Minh, people's leader.
My ass.
Well, I wasn't real sure I was hearing it right. I thought I better move before I got in the fight. Because my ears were hurting. My pulse started hitting the lip. Then I thought about another telegram that I just read, telling my buddy's wife that her husband was dead. It wasn't too long till I was feeling downright sick. Another held a sign that said, we won't fight. I thought to myself, oh, ain't that right? You'd rather let a soldier die instead. I said, it's a shame that every man who ever died there in that far-off land was dying so that you wouldn't have to wake up dead. Of course, he looked at me like I was kind of crazy.
That's a boyfriend, Toronto Blue Jays. Oh, Kennedy.
Well, I left that place. I went downtown to hit the first bar that I found.
What a lucky bastard he is, huh?
Pacify my brain. You see,
80s look. Digging it.
Little old place just north of Saigon. I had about an hour to catch myself a plane. So all I mean to say is, I don't like dying either.
Hell no.
I ain't gonna crawl.
Damn right. Like Morgan Freeman said in Shawshank Redemption in 1994, get busy living or get busy dying. Folks, keep living each and every day. Life in itself is a blessing. You only live once. Key to life is to enjoy it. Remember that. Never forget it, all right? On this day in 2013, speaking of Ho Chi Minh, how about Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam, will welcome its first McDonald's early that next year, which will be this year. The site will be run by the son of Vietnam's Prime Minister, Nguyen Tan Dung, Henry Nguyen. Okay. Yeah, I wonder if it would be like Russia and China when they got their first McDonald's. Just crazy. On this day in 1997, Listen to this crap. Gerald McKenzie awarded $266 million for being fired from Miller Brewing Company for sexual harassment for relaying a Seinfeld episode to a coworker. What the hell? Shit, I'm going to do something like that. I'll be set for life. 20 years ago today, remember, speaking of set for life, or at least she tried. 20 years ago today, Anna Nicole Smith, at the time 26 years old, wed billionaire J. Howard Marshall II, who was 89. Yeah, it's not like she wanted his old balls or anything. She wanted his freaking money. Come on. Nobody was stupid on that. Well, on this day in 1990, Ukraine declares independence. Happy Independence Day, Ukraine. I'll drink to that. On this day in 1981, Shikuni Sasaki spins 72 plates simultaneously. Why? Because he can. On this day in 1979, Premier President al-Bakr of Iraq is succeeded by that douchebag Saddam Hussein. Thank God he's dead. On this day in 1970, Cincinnati Reds spoiled the Pittsburgh Pirates' debut in Pittsburgh's Three River Stadium. They beat them 3-2. Three River Stadium, no longer. On this day in 1969, Apollo 11, carrying the first men to land on the moon, is launched. Who are those men, you say? Of course, Neil Armstrong, Edward Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins. That's the one that a lot of people forget. That'll make a good trivia question, just saying. Think about it, y'all. How about, on this day in 1956, last ringling brother Barnum and Bailey circus under a canvas tent. Whoop-de-doo, right? I know. Just in case somebody loves circuses. On this day in 1955, Golden Horseshoe Review, first of 50,000-plus performances at Disneyland, California. Land of Fruits and Nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. On this day in 1953, KROC, now known as KTTC-TV, Channel 10, Rochester, Minnesota, NBC affiliate, first broadcast. On this day in 1951, I know all y'all out there has read it, if you're old enough to read, if you're old enough to have graduated high school. You've read Catcher in the Rye by J.D. Salinger? Sure you have. Oh, I say in 1950. 1950, Dad. Honest day in 1950. 205,000 people. Record sports attendance. See the Brazil-Uruguay World Cup soccer match. Or everywhere else in the world, it's football except for the U.S. We just have to be different, Americans. Uruguay beat Brazil 2-1 in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Nothing like beating them on their home court. Speaking of that, Germany just recently beat Brazil on their home court, and Germany won the World Cup for 2014. On this day in 1945, first atomic bomb detonated Trinity site, Alamogordo, New Mexico. Now I won't want to live there. On this day in 1941, 100 degrees Fahrenheit, 38 Celsius for my metric friends. Where at, you say? Highest temperature ever recorded in Seattle, Washington. Wow. On this day in 1935, first automatic parking meter in the United States installed. Where at? Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Yup, southern Kansas, pretty much. On this day in 1926, National Geographic takes first natural color undersea photos. Pretty impressive. On this day in 1867, DJ Averill patents ready mixed paint. Very cool, dude. Thank you. On this day in 1862, David G. Farragut is the first rear admiral in the U.S. Navy. Rear Admiral. I don't know. That's just a messed up sounding rank for military. Just saying. On this day in 1861, Battle of Bull Run. The first major battle of the Civil War is fought. On this day in 1845, New York Yacht Club holds its first regatta for these rich boat racers. Hey! I got friends of mine that are rich and race boats, I guess. I can't. Hey! I'm here for all you fans, okay? On this day, 1798, U.S. Public Health Service forms, and the U.S. Marine Hospital is authorized. On this day, 1790, Congress establishes the District of Columbia, D.C., District of Columbia, where all the corruption's at. On this day, 1769, Father Junipero Serra founds Mission San Diego, the first mission in California. Very cool, San Diego. A city of over 1 million people now. On this day in 1661, first banknotes in Europe were issued by the Bank of Stockholm. Yes, folks, that's the capital of speed. On this day in 1548, La Paz, Bolivia is founded. On this day in 1439, kissing is banned in England to stop germs from spreading. Let me tell you something. The late, great George Carlin would roll in his grave hearing shit like that. Fear of germs? Why, these freaking wusses. Ugh! Kissing banned? Can you imagine that? That's dumb. On this day in 622, the origin of the Islamic era, Muharram 1, as the Muslim era begins, Mahomet, I don't know how to pronounce it, begins his flight from Mecca to Medina in Hijra. For my Islamic and Muslim friends out there, there you go. That's a very important day today, July 16th, 622. Let's drink to all those great days. Empty his brain cells on an average Yankee fan. Folks, y'all know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, time to make a fetus. I head out to everybody. Take care. Wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink a dying my spirit drink. Or you might kill yourself. Or somebody else and drinking and driving. It is dumber than being a Yankees fan, and what's dumber than that is rooting for puke-infested goober schnitzels like Eli.
I'm scared of Tom Brady.
Ha! Dream on, schmuck. Dream the hell on, Manning. Or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports, defends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Sorry, y'all. Sorry so long, but had to be done. Y'all come back now. Yeah.